Overnight, New South Wales had 38 cases of community transmission. Unfortunately, 11 had been infectious for a number of days in the community.
And a stark reminder of what this virus can do.
We've had 40 COVID patients admitted to hospital. There are 11 people in ICU, 3 of whom are ventilated.
As the outbreak changed shape and with lockdown extended by a week, the federal government rode to the rescue, suspending mutual obligations, waiving the means test for lockdown payments and fast-tracking vaccine supplies.
The federal government will be bringing forward an additional 300,000 extra doses targeted towards the areas of outbreak.
State authorities, meanwhile, zeroed in on transmissions in the home.
When we find a case in a family, we find that everyone in that household has the disease. You have symptoms? Even considering get all your household tested at the same time.
Please avoid visiting family and friends because you're not allowed to.
The frustration was clearly showing.
We are still having members of the community who will not comply.
Unfortunately, unintentionally at times, people don't do the right thing.
Where we do not get that compliance, we will enforce.
But it was more than matched by the press pack.
What would you say to people who feel that the southwestern suburbs are perhaps being unfairly singled out and maybe even blamed for an outbreak that started in the eastern suburbs?
Oh, look, that's never the intention of the New South Wales government, quite the contrary.
We feel like we're losing the battle. The feeling in the community is bordering on mutiny.
Surely the public's going to be more compliant with what you're asking them to do if they know exactly what it is you're trying to achieve.
Yeah, we are clearly trying to achieve stopping the transmission through the community.
And the elephant in the room made another appearance.
What is Plan B? And at what point do we need to accept the virus might be living in the community?
You can't live with the Delta variant unless you have a certain proportion of your population vaccinated. That's the bottom line.
Professor Catherine Bennett is the Chair of Epidemiology at Deakin University and joins us now. So, Catherine, we're 2 weeks into this. We've just recorded the worst numbers yet. Do you think the New South Wales government and public health team is losing control of this?
Look, I know we watch those numbers every day and we're really concerned when they do rise, but in fact, in epidemiological terms, this is still controlled. You're still seeing numbers that are manageable, and that's the most important thing at this stage, that you're not seeing that exponential rise in numbers. What's worrying is that half those cases, of course, today were people who are out in the community still, so that's the concern, that we still have cases that are being found after they're infectious.
So, Catherine, a lot of people think this lockdown hasn't been hard enough. Like, but are you saying the lockdown is working?
Look, it is working to contain it. It just hasn't allowed the health department to get on top of it, like get in front of it, which is what they need to do to really shut this virus down. What is reassuring, though, Pete, is that when you look at the sites that are appearing, there aren't that many sites per person. If you weren't in lockdown, there'd be a lot more. And the sites that are put out as exposure sites, particularly the close contact sites, are the sites that would be open even with a more strict lockdown, because these are your places to get food, petrol stations and so on. So it's the lockdown's working, it's doing its job to restrict the risk of transmission, but at the end of the day, you've still got to get to all those new cases and their contacts before they're infectious to really be able to close it down.
Does that mean that the discussion about whether the lockdown should be stricter is actually beside the point? Like, are you saying that if this lockdown was stricter, it wouldn't have made a difference at this point?
Well, not from what we're seeing, Waleed. We're looking at those transmission routes that they're describing, and they're either in these areas where you would have people carefully, you know, going about their business to get essentials. But also what we heard today was very much that emerging story of household-to-household transmission. And often in these communities where you've got very closely connected extended families across multiple households, the risk is that you've got people that live within 5 kilometres, for example, where putting other rules in place isn't going to address this. It's really about getting the message across that actually mixing, even with your own family across households, increase your risk of exposure and then increases the risk of that spreading across households. So that's the real message out of today.
Thanks for joining us tonight, Catherine. The language from government seems to be placing blame for the growing numbers on the people, but as recently as a fortnight ago, Gladys Berejiklian refused to call this a lockdown. Is the Premier's messaging from the start of this really the problem here?
I think we've struggled with messaging right across the board, Tony. I just think it's one of those areas where often the virus has to be handled in such a careful way. People have to realise how serious it is. but also they have to be very aware of what their actions are that are going to bring this under control. So it's trying to get that balance right.
The PM plans to bring forward 300,000 vaccines for Western Sydney, half Pfizer, half AstraZeneca. Is that going to be enough to make a difference?
I think everything helps, Lisa. This is additional dosage. It's not taking it off other states, which is good, and it just allows them to bring forward some of those second shots. What we also heard today from the Prime Minister was that only 50% of people over 70 in the community, particularly in those suburbs where they're most concerned about that transmission, 50% have a single dose. So trying to at least get some of those people onto their second dose and get others started will help. We've got 1 in 10 of those people infected at the moment in hospital. So every bit of vaccine out there, particularly in those focused areas of concern, that everything helps.
We heard in that press conference just then the confusion about exactly what the government is trying to achieve in order to get out of lockdown. Do you think the government should be giving New South Wales a roadmap out, or is it too early?
I'm expecting that we will hear more over the days. They've also really highlighted those cases that are in the community and infectious as being that key indicator of how controlled this is and how much, you know, they're relying on lockdown really is because they have those cases that are still mixing before they are identified. So they'll want those numbers down. If they don't go down, if this turns out to be a holding pattern and those numbers remain, then that's when you absolutely need to hear what are the next steps. Is this so localised you do something more locally and start to open up schools and other things elsewhere? Or how do you proceed once they've really worked with community leaders to close it down?
Catherine, thanks so much for your clarity tonight. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Waleed.